this is the ultimate arrival point of this program. I think to do it in one of the most cutting-edge technological buildings in the world is a very important point in our journey. Hopefully from here, it will go to many other places, both science institutions and art institutions as well.
There is an added level of excitement and je ne sais quoi doing it here for the opening of the Quantum Nano Center. The layout and the nature of this particular concert hall is really something, and it's very well suited for this concert. Very intimate, everything is very close. It's really very, very effective here, and so that adds an additional dimension of depth to this particular performance.
Welcome to this incredible venue for this concert, our second iteration of the Quantum Music at the Frontier of Science. For us, it's an amazing thing to play in a building like this. That to me, the arts and the sciences exist in dialogue. That orchestras belong and should be more often in the world of ideas, and this program was part of that. Now, I think we are ready to enter into this concert and, in fact, into the quantum world. Here we go.
Both physics and music describe our surroundings, but with different agendas. One rational, one emotional. Physics reveals a reality beyond what we see and hear. In the world of quantum physics, things can be in two places at once, and concepts like teleportation become real possibilities. There is also a brave new world of music evoking feelings and experiences alien to most of us. These worlds can be bracing, weird, disorienting, and beautiful. To understand how we got here, let's begin a few centuries ago with two key figures in physics and music. Isaac Newton described the natural laws that govern our universe. Mozart expressed the beauty of Newton's laws with music full of structure and symmetry.
In the music of Mozart, as in Newtonian physics, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. And in Mozart's music, there is an order and symmetry that we still find very pleasing.
Change color the way it does when heated. Scientists propose that light must be emitted in discrete packets, or quanta. It was the beginning of quantum physics. After all of this boundary pushing, composers around 1900 were left in a quandary. How much further could they go?
Anton Webern began composing in a lush post-Wagnerian style. Listen to this piece, his Langsamer Satz, a piece he wrote for strings in 1905. Draws his notes from mathematical sources never before used in music. It's the soundtrack of its time. It's music of exploration, mystery, and discovery.
favor. Scientists of the early 1900s realized Newton's laws couldn't sufficiently describe their findings. One of the first experiments to unveil this strange world was the double slit experiment. Its results were elegantly counterintuitive, and it has been named the most beautiful experiment in physics. The experimental results showed that quantum particles could not only be in certain positions, but also in superpositions, not simply here or there, but both here and there.
In 1906, the American composer Charles Ives wrote a piece that perfectly echoes the struggles that scientists and musicians were facing in the early 20th century. It's called The Unanswered Question. The unanswered question is asked by the trumpet. Flutes and clarinets attempt to answer the trumpet's questions, but always fail, getting more and more frustrated each time. Think of this piece as a musical gateway into the quantum world.
Ideas of melody and structure. They were discarding them altogether in favor of new modes and ideas, contrary to hundreds of years of musical intuition. In fact, the music you'll hear from now on is directly inspired by science.
Around the middle of the 20th century, when quantum science unveiled strange new dimensions beyond our experience, the composer Henry Brandt explored new dimensions in music. He believed along with the three traditional dimensions of music, rhythm, pitch, and timbre, there was a fourth, space. When the orchestra plays this next piece by Brandt, do more than listen. Try to physically feel how the spatial arrangement of sounds affects your experience.
By the 1950s, science took a more pragmatic approach to quantum physics. Physicists hunkered down and cranked out equations guided by the simple phrase. But in the late 1960s and 70s, things began to change. A young generation of free-thinking physicists began to revisit and rethink the deepest questions of quantum mechanics. They found inspiration and beauty in the very things that were driving the shut-up-and-calculate people crazy. The American composer John Cage shared the intrepid spirit of these physicists in the 1960s and 70s. He composed Atlas Eclipticalis by copying the positions of stars and galaxies onto transparencies. What you will experience is the soundtrack of nature's grandest ongoing physics experiment, the universe itself. Thank you. now we'd like to introduce you to a very different kind of composer, one from the shut-up-and-calculate school of thought, Yanis Xanakis. Xanakis was one of the world's first composers to use a computer to write music, or rather, to program computers to essentially write the music themselves. He was the architect of the music, the computer was the builder. Consider this a taste of your computer's creative, artistic side. Quantum objects being in two states simultaneously, imagine a computer that not only utilizes bits of one or zero, but quantum bits that are simultaneously one and zero. The speed up this provides to computation is amazing. In fact, it's exponential, redoubling over and over again.
I'd like to do a little kind of sound experiment. So I'm just going to add one player at a time, playing the same notes at a regular rhythm, and just, you know, count and see how long it takes to get everyone playing. Here we go. At an exponential rate, 1, 2, 4, 8, and so forth. There we go. This is how long that takes. A lot faster.
The physicist Paul Davies once said, "The 19th century was the machine age, the 20th century was the information age. I believe the 21st century will go down as the quantum age." Predict exactly what lies ahead in music or in science. We know there will be new pioneers, new works of genius, new directions we never considered going. We believe composers will always react to and interpret scientific discovery. We expect today's concert won't be the last quantum symphony. We know the universe is endlessly fascinating, endlessly beautiful. Something going on just beyond our expectations. The trick is to never stop looking deeper.
Okay.